One of my favorite things to draw. That's what I'm drawing now is eyeballs because they're so easy.
So I'm JB, JB in the cut at yahoo.com. Write me up. I'm an artist. I do all types of art. I draw, I tattoo, I like fashion, I like music. Jack of all trades.
Ooh, I had to be like 6 or 7 or something like that, maybe. I first was drawing Ghostbusters and Ninja Turtles at first. Well, I like some of everything, man. I like performance arts, visual arts. I do photography sometimes. Tattoos, I like tattoos. Tattoos is a good passion. And I just like to be versatile in some of all the stuff. I like all things that are art. I've been drawing since I've been little, since I can remember. My mom was a big influence on my art, so watching her, I just always wanted my own cartoons and stuff like that. I just wanted to, you know, to show my art and, you know, be good at it. Some of the stuff I had got into when I was younger and stuff like that, like, art was always kind of really big in our family, whether it was photography or people dressing nice and, you know, movies and stuff like that. Like, we've always been like a real artsy kind of family, so we do all types of stuff. My favorite artist of all time is Basquiat. Just that street style art that he did, some of the graffiti and stuff that he did was, I mean, that shit was great, man. Like, for sure, to come from the slums and, you know, really kind of put his art out there when nobody else was trying to look at it, you know, force it on everybody and stuff. Like, that was big. My second favorite artist, of course, is Bruce Timm. He's famous for doing the Batman animated series. I mean, it's perfectly drawn, in my opinion. I mean, all that art on that black paper just looks just amazing. My third favorite artist is, of course, the always great Akira Tomizaki, right? From Dragon Ball Z. Like, if it wasn't for his style of art, like, I wouldn't have been as good as I am. Like, learning how to draw that. And that just made me so much better, like, learning the anatomy and stuff like that. It was all through Dragon Ball Z. And I think most of my peers who were drawing art in the time were like really big on that. So that was like a major influence. So of course the first one I'm for sure show you is like one of the first ones that actually survived. All that, the ones I didn't keep. So the very first one that I drew that I remember that I kept from all that stuff was this one.
What's up with that one?
That was from 2008. That's Yahweh in Hebrew or God in Hebrew. That is peace. That's when I first started tattooing too. So that was some of my first tattoo flash I had did. These were the ones that I did when I got good. I started drawing like real heavy. So of course, I was really big on like Man's Ruin and stuff like that when I first got into tattooing and stuff like that. So the one that really jumps out at me, I think that had emotional content was this one. The road to hell is paved with good intentions. Jim Lee is famous for drawing Superman a lot. So like a lot of pictures you guys see of Superman and stuff like that, he's probably like the majority artist. He also drew for X-Men back in the day in the 90s that made their comic books like really like jump off the paper and stuff like that. So he really got me to want to draw like art and like really experiment with color and stuff like that. Like he was really good. So this is probably one of my favorite ones is Lulu. Oh, I met her at a laundromat. I met Lulu at the laundromat. I was bored as hell. I was like in a drawing streak at the time. And I was like, damn, like she was pretty. So I was like, you know, you mind if I draw you while my clothes dry? So she let me draw and stuff like that. When I got home.
A real person you drew?
Yeah, it was a real person I drew at the laundromat. So I did like a rough copy when I was at the laundromat. Then I got home, I polished it up, gave her some color and stuff like that.
What's the story behind this one?
This one was after a breakup. So it kind of represents like kind of like letting go of something like extremely toxic. This was the first time I had used artist pencils too. So that was like a different style that I had did. Like you normally I use like number 2 and number 1 pencils. It's one I just did recently. I think honestly it's probably the best work I've done so far. It's my Momentum the Squid Game. But yeah, it just represents different things of the show. Like she was actually supposed to be like something different. It was just something about the show that was just like, I gotta draw it. I gotta draw like my version of it. Like not my version, but like how I feel about the show type shit. So it was different too. Cause like, it was the first time I had used a ruler too to really kind of get the mask right. I normally like draw and doodle and stuff like that. But like, that's just for like just fun. But like, if I want to do something like really big and like really artsy and stuff like that, like I would do like a really elaborate picture and stuff like that. And I would put like different elements of art
into one picture or something. Like some people will draw exactly what they see. I'm one of those people who have like 12 different reference pictures up to draw like one thing. So it's like I want to tell a story what I'm drawing and stuff like that. So I try my best to put like all types of like elements in it and not just one. First, the early childhood, of course, is Bugs. Bugs is just like what everybody wanted to be. Greatly drawn, like his facial expressions was dope. Bart Simpson, I mean, everybody was in love with Bart. Bart was another one that's really good drawn, really good character development. I actually like how Steven Universe is drawn, actually. Like the palette of colors that it has, you know, that soft artwork sometimes with those soft lines and stuff like that. Like, man, that stuff is like really, really good. Honestly, I really want to do something like with film more than anything and stuff like that. Like really like directing like my own film or like really just like having like my own comic book or something like that. Like art is the limit, you know what I'm saying? You can do so much with all of it, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to hold myself down to just one like genre, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like I want to be a pioneer like in all the art.